All right, we're going to solve a value mixture problem using two variables. By value mixture, we're talking about like costs. So here's an example. Beth combined punch worth 80 cents a quart with some juice worth $2.40 per quart to get an 8-quart mixture worth $1.40 a quart. How much punch was used? Okay, well, let's draw a picture. We're mixing punch with juice. So how about I just sort of make a little vat of each? Let's say that's the punch in here and the juice is in here. If you want, you could like squiggle so you can imagine it's liquid. And I'm going to pour it into this big container. Okay. Now, what do I know about the quantities? How much punch and how much juice? Well, I don't know how much punch, and I also don't know how much juice. But I do know that there's 8 quarts in the mixture. And since I know neither of these, this is where the two variables come in nice and handy. Let's just let one of them be x and the other one be y. Right, what other information is here? We are given the price per quart in each of these containers. So the unit price per quart, I'm going to write underneath. Let's see, how much is the punch worth? 80 cents. Now I could write 0.8 or 0.80. I'm going to go ahead and do everything in cents. That way I don't have to work with decimals. So this will just be 80 cents. Just remember I'm doing everything in cents. The juice was 240 a quart, so that's 240. And the mixture, that was $1.40, so that's 140. So remember the you don't add the two prices together. The mixture's got to be somewhere in the middle somewhere, right? Some number between 80 and 240. So that's why it's 140. Now, let's consider the cost of each of these containers. Right. What's the cost in the first container? Well, you've got X quarts, 80 cents each, right? So it's going to be 80 times however many quarts you are. That's how many cents it's going to cost. 80 times X, your price times however much you have. Second one, how much is in here? Well, 240 is the cost per quart, and I've got Y quarts, so that's going to be 240Y. And in the mixture, I actually could figure that out. That's going to be 140 times 8. I'm just going to write down 140 times 8, but of course, you get out your calculator and get this. And the key is to realizing that the cost should be the same as adding the price for these two separately as just the total cost of the entire mixture. So this is one equation. The cost of the punch plus the cost of the juice is the same as just the cost once it's all mixed together. Okay? So that's going to be one equation. Now, we can simplify this equation a little bit. You do not have to, but I'm going to show you how you could simplify it. If you divide by some common factors that go into all three numbers, it is going to make it easier. So let's say I wanted to do that. Well, I see 8 goes into all these numbers, so if I divide each of these by 8, that's going to cancel, right? So let's see what we have so far. That gives me 10x. Now, if I do 8 into 240, that's 30y. And the 8s cancel here completely. I'm just going to get 140. That's why I didn't bother multiplying the 140 times 8, just in case. And then you might notice one more thing here. 10 goes into all these numbers. So you could divide everything by 10 and get an even easier problem. I always like to make my arithmetic as easy as possible before I do my algebra. So x plus 3y equals 14. So what I'm saying is, this equation that we started off with 80x plus 240y equals 140 times 8 is the same as x plus 3y equals 14 when I divided both sides by 80, basically, which you could do, right, for an equation. So this is one equation that arises from this original picture. And what's the other equation? Well, however much punch I have in this container and however much juice I have in this container, I'm pouring it into this big mixture. So my other equation is just what's in this container, when I add it to what's in the second container, it's equal to what's in the third container. So the amount of juice, x plus y, I'm sorry, the amount of punch plus the amount of juice, x plus y, is equal to 8. So my other equation is x plus y equals 8. And now I get two equations that are going to be pretty easy to solve here. I could use the substitution method, or you can use the addition method. So here are our two equations, and now I'm going to go ahead and use the subtraction method, or addition method if you want to call it that, by multiplying the bottom equation by negative 1, so that we've got these two equations. The first one I'm leaving as is, x plus 3y equals 14, and now I'm multiplying every term on both sides of the equation by negative 1, negative x minus y equals negative 8. And adding, I have 2y equals 6, or y equals 3. So y is 3. Now, if we go back to one of these equations, how about the x plus y equals 8? If y is 3, hopefully you'll note that x must be 5, right? Because 5 plus 3 is 8. You can go back to either equation, but that was the most natural and easy one to solve for. So now I've got to go back, and remember, we've got x is y, x is 5, y is 3, and we're going to go back to how we define those variables in the first place. X was the amount of punch, y was the amount of juice. So now we're going to see if that makes sense given the original problem. So x was 5 and y was 3. Remember, that's what we got for x and y. So here was the original problem, and we got that x was 5, and remember that stood for how much punch we used. So we've got 5 quarts of punch, and y stood for how much juice, so we have 3 quarts of juice. Now the question says how much punch was used, so our answer looks like it's going to be 5 quarts. But now we definitely want to check to make sure that makes sense. So it says she combined punch worth 80 cents a quart. Now we're going to look and make sure using money and calculators if you need to. So what we have is we've got 80 cents, right? So we're going to talk about the punch. She's got 80 cents of the punch, and I'm using 5 quarts of punch, right? So we've got 80 cents times 5 quarts. That's going to be $4 on the punch. All right, now what about the juice? The juice is 240 a pound, and we've got that we're using 3 quarts. So I have to do 240 times 3, and I think that's 720. So that comes out to $11.20. So if I purchased them separately and mixed them together, it's $11.20. Now we want to check that against just the price of the mixture, right? So is that the same as the mixture price? So the mixture price, I've got a whole 8 quarts, right, at $1.40 a quart. So we do 8 times $1.40, and we also get 11.20, so it does check. So our answer is that for the amount of punch, we're going to use 5 quarts of punch.